Hello, welcome back to my channel. Thank you for coming back to watch another video. Happy Vlogmas. 5 o'clock on the dot. I'm in my drop top. Wait, can't do that. If you're new here, my name is Angela. I lost 200 pounds, fell in love with running. Now I'm trying to live the healthiest life that I possibly can while raising my toddler. Today is Thursday, and you know, Starbucks has happy hour on Thursdays, and so I went to happy hour and I got 2 drinks, but you know, I don't have anyone to share my other drink with. So I got 1 drink for today and then 1 drink with no ice for tomorrow. That's how you beat the system. I don't know why it keeps doing this lighting thing. It makes it really hard to edit my videos too. I thought that I would just have a little sit down with you because I feel like that my videos have gotten a little bit monotonous with the things that I do because, you know, I go to work, I play with my child, and I work out, and then I come home and do mom stuff around the house and edit my video, and then I go to sleep. So I'd not focus too much on that today because I think that you've gotten the idea of what my life is like during Vlogmas. So I thought, I don't know, this morning something kind of like popped in my head because people, I don't know, someone had said something to me yesterday. And I was just thinking about how has weight loss changed you? And, you know, that's just a question that's very general or whatever. It's not really how weight loss changed me. It's like how other people look at me now that I've lost the weight. Definitely people were a lot friendlier. People were more willing to talk to me. People that never talked to me before talk to me now. I mean, and it's still like that. And that's just the thing that we have to remember about the world. I probably have all types of crusty stuff in my mouth. But this is the thing that we all have to remember about the world. Because then this idea kind of popped into my head again because someone was talking about, does it make it, I watched an interview with Emma Chamberlain about how her channel blew up and what made her so real is that she didn't put herself together and she was just being her authentic self when she was making her YouTube videos. And you know, like, I live in a world where obviously I'm black and you don't really see a lot of black influencers that aren't like celebrity, like famous out there in the world. That's, you know, those are just things that I have, that I think about on a regular basis. There aren't really a lot of people of color that are sponsored athletes, that are brand ambassadors or anything like that out in the world. And, you know, and if there is, then sometimes you kind of feel like the token black kid. And I've always been like the token black kid my whole entire life. So, like, I wasn't black enough to hang out with the black kids. I wasn't white enough to hang out with the white kids. So I just, you know, I was kind of shoved in the middle there. And that's just kind of like been what my whole life is. And so that's why I say that about weight loss. People looked at me differently until I lost the weight. And then all of a sudden I became like a cool person to hang out with. And maybe that was because I was on Rachel Ray and we did, you know, the CNN and the Today Show and all that stuff. And then all of a sudden I became cool. That's just a weird thing. And so then in turn, it makes it harder for me to put myself out there because I'm like, are people really accepting me for who I am or for other reasons? You know, that's just the way that the world works. You know, people are going to talk to you because you have the right look or you do the right things or you know the right people or things like that. And you know, it kind of sucks because I'm looking for authenticity in my life and not just like fake friends or fake people or anything, you know. So there are people out there that are looking for authenticity, and maybe we should start focusing on that just a little bit. I know that was a little rant, but hey, we're gonna go with it. And that may be all that the video is today. My child has a Christmas musical tonight, and we're gonna go see what that's all about. I'm gonna be honest, I've never ever really been a fan of like these children type things, but now I have a child, so I kinda have to be like into this. This is mom's first experience doing something like this, you know, child Christmas program related. So let's see how mom feels. Thank you. just finished with the Christmas musicale, and Little Miss really was shaking her hips. I have to stop now because I'm driving. Okay, so we are back. Child is watching Frozen. She dressed up like her Christmas tree, and that's what she's talking about. She danced and she had a good time, and it was really cute. And to think that I almost bailed on the Christmas program because I just didn't know if it was gonna be something cute or not. Fun, but it was worth it. She had a good time. I guess the moral of the story today is the one thing that I've learned, especially from getting up there and watching those kids, especially how I started out my video, is that you just have to be you. You have to be confident in yourself and just be you and do what makes you feel good. You know, just be you. It doesn't matter what color you are, what type you are, if you're small, you're fat, overweight, whatever. I know it doesn't matter. Just be you and be confident in yourself, and you can do whatever you want to do. That's the most important thing, and that is what I learned from a Christmas program. So thank you for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up, leave a comment down below if you're ready for Christmas, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.
Yeah.
Okay, we just finished with the Christmas musicale and Little Miss Madeline, or Little Miss, really was shaking her hips. I have to stop now because I'm driving. Okay, so we are back. Child is watching Frozen. She dressed up like her Christmas tree, and that's what she's talking about. She danced and she had a good time, and it was really cute. And to think that I almost bailed on the Christmas program because I just didn't know if it was gonna be something cute or fun, but it was worth it. She had a good time. I guess the moral of the story today is the one thing that I've learned, especially from getting up there and watching those kids, especially how I started out my video, is that you just have to be you. You have to be confident in yourself and just be you and do what makes you feel good. You know, just be you. It doesn't matter what color you are, what type you are, if you're small, you're fat, overweight, whatever. I know. It doesn't matter. Just be you and be confident in yourself, and you can do whatever you want to do. That's the most important thing, and that is what I learned from a Christmas program. So thank you for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment down below if you're ready for Christmas. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.